Thanks for joining us tonight. I'm Hunter Holbert.
And I'm Jess Arnold. California legislators are debating if they should get rid of the personal belief exemption in the wake of the measles outbreak. State lawmakers introduced a bill Wednesday that would require children to be fully vaccinated before going to school. While the exemption has been in effect since the 1960s, California has seen an increase in the number of parents taking it in the past decade. Now, numerous other parents are requesting for the law's removal to make public places safer for their children. This outbreak began in Southern California in December and has spread to 14 other states. The total is up to 107 cases of the contagious illness.
NBC Nightly News anchor Brian Williams is on temporary leave. Williams announced Saturday that he would take himself off the broadcast while NBC investigates accusations about his inaccurate reporting. The NBC News president said Friday that they are looking into Williams' false on-air statements that he was in a helicopter hit by enemy fire in Iraq in 2003. The anchor has since apologized for the statements, but now some people are questioning his reporting on Hurricane Katrina in 2005. Nightly News has been the top-rated evening newscast for more than a decade. It is still unclear how the incident will affect the network or if and when Williams will be back.
At least 22 people are reportedly dead following a clash with police at a soccer game in Egypt late Sunday. Police fired tear gas into a corridor of the military air defense stadium in East Cairo during a match between clubs Zamalek and NP. The victims died from a combination of suffocation from the gas in addition to being trampled. Egypt's internal ministry claims many of the gassed guests were trying to enter the stadium without tickets, but witnesses say otherwise. Egyptian government ordered play of the country's Premier League to be suspended indefinitely. Experts say this most recent clash is a prime example of the unrest in Egypt since the 2011 uprising that removed President Hosni Mubarak.
A jet crashed into the river in Taipei last Wednesday. CNN reports the crash of a Trans Airways flight killed at least 40 people, with less than 10 surviving the crash. The Taipei City Fire Department recovered five more bodies on Saturday, while three still remain missing. Many dashboard camera videos showed the plane jet scraping a highway overpass before hurling into the river. A possible professional error reportedly caused one of the two engines of the jet to shut down about 37 seconds after takeoff. The head of Taiwan's Aviation Safety Council said on Saturday that it was too early to reach definite conclusions.
ISIS claimed on Friday that its sole known remaining American hostage has been killed in a Jordanian airstrike. Fox News reports U.S. intelligence officials are investigating this claim. The hostage was Kayla Mueller, an aid worker held by ISIS for nearly a year and a half. Mueller left to go to Syria in December 2012 to help refugees. She was captured on August 4, 2013. The 26-year-old was never featured on any hostage videos, which leads intelligence officials to believe that some hostages were killed long before the Islamic State claims. They still remain hopeful that Kayla is alive.
CNN reported Jordan executed two al-Qaeda prisoners before dawn on Wednesday. The killings were in response to the murder of pilot Mu'adh al-Qasasbeh by ISIS. A government spokesman said Jordan executed jihadists Sajida al-Rishawi and Ziad Karbouli. The day before the executions, ISIS released video and stills of the Jordanian pilot being burned alive in a cage. Jordan had been negotiating for the pilot's release unknowingly after the incident allegedly took place. It is believed that the killing was in retaliation to Jordan joining the coalition against ISIS in Iraq and Syria.
The U.S. and Germany are taking a stand against Russian aggression in the Ukraine. President Obama said earlier today that Russian President Vladimir Putin has violated every commitment from previous deals made regarding the Ukraine. Obama held a joint press conference with German Chancellor Angela Merkel, saying that Putin's aggression has strengthened the U.S.'s ties to its European allies. He also hinted at possibly arming Ukraine with weaponry. Despite Merkel saying Germany does not support the measure, so far the nations will continue with their economic sanctions of Russia.
State college taxis have new competition. Find out more coming up.
All right, you ready for some baseball trivia?
Let's do it.
What year produced the most no-hit games in the big leagues?
Seven no-hitters in 1990.
Wow, that's right. Now a question that's not trivial. How many children will witness bullying this year? The answer? 3 out of 4.
75%?
That's wow. Right. How many of them will say something?
Kids want to help, but don't know how. Teach them how to stop bullying and be more than a bystander at stopbullying.gov.
Wow, these are really good.
You act surprised.
Mm.
Practice makes perfect.
You don't have to be perfect to be a perfect parent. There are thousands of teens in foster care who don't need perfection. They need you.
Enroll.
Every budget, so don't accept defeat.
Now you can get covered and still
buy me treats.
You take care of your pets. Now it's their turn to take care of you. Visit getcoveredamerica.org to learn about your health insurance options.
A freshman student at Millersville University was found dead with her boyfriend trying to revive her yesterday. Gregorio Arrastieta is charged with aggravated assault after telling police he shoved his girlfriend Carly Hall in her dorm, causing her to hit her head. Campus police responded to a call at 5:30 a.m. for cardiac arrest to find Arrastieta performing CPR on Hall. Her cause of death will be determined by an autopsy. Hall was 18 years old. Arrastieta is currently being held on $1.5 million bail.
The Phi Sigma Kappa fraternity was suspended on Tuesday. A woman reported two sexual assaults by the same male who was visiting the fraternity. The Daily Collegian reported that the assault came to the Penn State Police's attention through an online reporting form. However, the assault was said to have occurred sometime between Saturday and Monday last week. State College police are currently investigating the assault, and the fraternity has been placed on full chapter suspension. They are prohibited from hosting any organized events, including social events, until the investigation concludes.
A Penn State graduate was convicted of being the mastermind behind the black market website, The Silk Road. The Washington Post reports 30-year-old Ross Ulbricht was found guilty for running the $1.2 billion business from 2011 to 2013. He was operating under the name Dread Pirate Roberts. The Silk Road was an unregulated online marketplace for selling anything from illegal drugs to hacking tutorials. A federal jury found Ulbricht guilty of all seven criminal charges. He currently faces life in prison with a minimum sentence of 30 years. Ulbricht spent 3 years at Penn State, where he earned a graduate degree in material sciences.
Governor Tom Wolf announced Wednesday that Centre County Judge Thomas King Kistler will be named to the Pennsylvania Supreme Court. The Center Daily Times reported that he and the Dean of Duquesne University Law School, Ken Gormley, will complete the terms of two former justices through the end of this year. The two men will replace Chief Justice Ronald Castile, who retired, and Justice Seamus McCaffrey, who resigned last year following a pornographic email scandal. If confirmed, Kistler will have to resign from his current position as a common pleas judge in Center County.
The executive secretary position in Penn State's Graduate and Professional Student Association is now open. The Daily Collegian is reporting that Secretary Jeffrey Masco resigned Wednesday. This action follows multiple charges about his inappropriate conduct that were read at the GPSA meeting. The judiciary accuses Masco of publishing a personal statement on the GPSA newswire and taking inaccurate and incomplete minutes. Masco neither accepted nor rejected the charges, but did call the charges a joke. He then distributed a formal statement of resignation, which is against GPSA policy, resulting in threats to call the police.
Penn Staters now have a new way to get around town. Popular car service Uber launched in State College on Friday as part of its experimental two-year contract with the Public Utility Commission. The company, which has taken off in over 200 cities to date, connects riders to drivers with a mobile app. According to the Daily Collegian, General Manager for Uber Technologies in Pennsylvania, Jennifer Crucius, says the company will be doing a seven-year multi-state background checks on its State College drivers for any criminal charges or sex, drug, and traffic offenses. However, due to its flexible rates, many are worried that Uber's launch will hurt the local cab companies.
THON is just around the corner, and Penn State basketball is game to support Four Diamonds. Here's Scott Sikowski with the story.
It's THON Hoops Day here at the Bryce Jordan Center as families will get together for a chance to watch Penn State basketball as the men face off against Nebraska.
The Nittany Lions put on a show in front of over 70 THON families at the event as they led the game from start to finish. In between game action, the THON children got a chance to participate in an array of activities with cheerleaders and THON committee members. At halftime, the children in attendance were honored as the heroes of the day. The organization they are a part of, as well as personal fun facts, were announced as they walked onto the court. Dancer relations captain Emily O'Cunahern shared her thoughts on the event.
One of my favorite things about THON is how it really is like a year-long effort. So there's so many events throughout the year. This is just one of the really big things. There was such a great turnout with all the families today, which is pretty obvious just from being here in the stands. I know a lot of committees were here, a lot of orgs were here supporting their families, and I just really think it gets everyone hyped up.
Head football coach James Franklin joined in on the fun with his family and explained why THON is so important to the community.
Well, not only does it make a huge impact in raising money and bringing awareness, but the connection with the kids and the connection with the family, to me, is the real impact. And that's what I was blown away with last year and since we've been here.
When the game concluded, dancer relation captains performed a 2014 line dance with a little help.
The event was just as successful as the game, as Penn State defeated Nebraska 56-43. For Penn State News, I'm Scott Sikowski.
We'll be right back with an interview featuring an independent dancer couple for THON 2015. Stay tuned.
Every budget, so don't accept defeat.
Now you can get covered in steel.
Buy me treats.
You take care of your pets. Now it's their turn to take care of you. Visit GetCoveredAmerica.org to learn about your health insurance options.
Wow, these are really good.
You act surprised. Practice makes perfect.
You don't have to be perfect to be a perfect parent. There are thousands of teens in foster care who don't need perfection. They need you.
Pretty much a good day for me would be people leaving their hands off of me. I'm always called names. Everywhere that I go, there's always someone calling me names, calling me gay. I've been choked, thrown up against a wall, punched. Nobody's ever tried to help me.
Welcome back to PSN News. I'm Mike Gilbert here with Tony Hunt and Victoria LaGuardia, an independent dancer couple for THON 2015. Guys, thanks for joining us. Congratulations on being selected.
Thanks for having us.
And have you guys been involved with THON before this?
Yeah, we've definitely both been involved with THON. Since my freshman year, I've been on an R&R committee. This year, though, I took the whole year to dedicate myself to the independent dancer kind of function.
Yeah, and since freshman year, I've been on three different THON committees, all different committees since freshman year, and this year I'm on a communications committee and I did the independent dancing process with Victoria.
And what kind of responsibilities did that entail, the other committees, things like that?
Well, for R&R, we just kind of did security throughout the whole BJC during the weekend. So up until the weekend, we would learn about what things could come into the BJC during THON, what couldn't, what people could and couldn't do. So the basic stuff of telling people not to sit, not to pass things from the floor to the stands or vice versa. So just basically the safety procedures of THON and making sure that we enforce them during the weekend.
So why'd you guys decide to become independent dancers?
Take it.
You can take it.
We've been really involved in THON since freshman year. And this year we kind of wanted to take it to the next level. And independent dancing is completely on your own. You're not relying on an organization or anything. It's just the two of us and our friends.
Right.
And we thought that was kind of the greatest way to put all our personal contribution stamp on THON this year. So we really wanted to give it a go and say that we had a personal hand in raising funds for THON this year.
And how did you raise those funds?
We did a lot of different things. We definitely took part in the canning weekends this year. Not only did we go on different canning trips with our friends, but we also had friends who would go with their committees and then credit whatever they made on their canning trips to our individual kind of mini org, which is what we are as an independent dancer couple. We also did THON envelopes, which are a huge, huge help.
Right.
We sent those out to our family members, our friends' family members. We just kind of sent them out to basically anybody we could.
Besides that, THON's getting real high-tech with their things. So
right.
We had our own peer-to-peer donating page, and we pushed that a lot and did a lot of social media type things as well.
Right. So what are you guys looking forward to most for THON weekend?
Like I said, we've been involved with THON for years, and
right.
I've met a lot of incredible volunteers through THON, and I've gotten to know and become friends with a lot of them, and I'm really excited to stand this year in the fight against pediatric cancer with all of them. I think that's what I'm most excited for, is these people that I put in so many hours with. We're about to stand together 4 to 6 hours, including Victoria.
Yeah, I'm definitely really excited to just kind of take in this whole experience now in like a completely different way. We've both taken it in the past 2 years as committee members and kind of volunteers. This year we're going to be volunteers, but a completely different kind. So we're going to be there the whole time on our feet. And we're just going to get a whole new experience, you know, just kind of. And I'm just really ready for that. I'm really excited about that.
Tony and Victoria, we all appreciate what you do, and so does the whole Penn State community. Thanks for coming out tonight. We'll be back after this.
All right, you ready for some baseball trivia?
Let's do it.
What year produced the most no-hit games in the big leagues?
7 no-hitters in 1990.
Wow, that's right. Now a question that's not trivial. How many children will witness bullying this year?
Huh.
The answer? 3 out of 4.
75%?
That's wow. Right. How many of them will say something?
Kids want to help, but don't know how. Teach them how to stop bullying and be more than a bystander at stopbullying.gov.
Wow, these are really good.
You act surprised. Practice makes perfect.
You don't have to be perfect to be a perfect parent. There are thousands of teens in foster care who don't need perfection. They need you.
Enroll. Every budget, so don't accept defeat. Now you can get covered and still
buy me treats.
You take care of your pets. Now it's their turn to take care of you. Visit GetCoveredAmerica.org to learn about your health insurance options.
From the students of Penn State Meteorology, here is your Penn State Campus Weather Service forecast.
Good evening, Penn State. Student meteorologist Faith Aritz here with your Campus Weather Service forecast for February 9th, 2015. We will start out here as usual with your weather headlines for the week. These past couple days have been pretty mild and messy here in central Pennsylvania, with relatively warm temperatures and a weird mix of rain and snow over the past several hours. And that will continue for just a little while longer until we transition completely to snow for the middle of your week. The story this week, however, is definitely the weekend cool down that we will be seeing. Temperatures dipping down into the single digits some nights in the next several days. Definitely keep your eye out for that and bundle up. Luckily, though, tonight, nothing too out of the ordinary with the precip from today tapering off just a little bit overnight as the calm winds stick around and temperatures drop down only into the high 20s. Nothing too much to worry about tonight in the way of wintry weather. Tomorrow, the flurries will stick around, but no accumulation is expected with this system. A high around 36 degrees, which is pretty balmy for this time of year, and these calm winds sticking around. So again, nothing too much to worry about in the next several days. Really much of the usual. This weekend, we will continue to see some pretty usual weather for Valentine's Day, especially overcast skies and a high temperature only in the low 20s. Nighttime temperatures will be much chillier than that, so definitely bundle up if you plan on celebrating this Hallmark holiday this weekend. The remainder of your week before that will be pretty usual here in State College. We will see some snow showers on Thursday, but as those clouds clear out to make for a sunny Friday, temperatures will plummet down into the single digits overnight. Definitely make sure you are ready for that. Once the sun sets and the clouds clear out, temperatures can drop very quickly. You do not want to get caught in that frigid weather. And after that, the cold temperatures will stick around for the remainder of your forecast, barely hitting 20 degrees on Saturday, with kind of a mix of sun and clouds throughout the remainder of your weekend. From the Penn State Campus Weather Service, I'm Faith Aritz. Have a great evening and stay tuned for sports up next on PSN.
Every budget, so don't accept defeat.
Now you can get covered and still
buy me treats.
You take care of your pets. Now it's their turn to take care of you. Visit GetCoveredAmerica.org to learn about your health insurance options.
Oh, look, a redhead.
Staring contest.
Still got it.
I know.
Come alive with the forest.
The dad was cute.
You were looking right at us.
Visit discovertheforest.org to find a forest near you.
You sure you don't want some? It's chamomile.
Listen, you are extremely terrifying. Just the scariest undead subhuman thing on TV, and I really mean that. But I am worried that you could give my kids nightmares if they see you, so I'm gonna have to block you. So that's it. Oh, and tell the zombies they're blocked too.
Pretty much a good day for me would be people leaving their hands off of me. I'm always called names. Everywhere that I go, there's always someone calling me names, calling me gay. I've been choked, thrown up against a wall, punched. Nobody's ever tried to help me. Pretty much a good day for me would be people leaving their hands off of me. I'm always called names. Everywhere that I go, there's always someone calling me names, calling me gay. I've been choked, thrown up against a wall, punched. Nobody's ever tried to help me.
Hello, everyone. I'm Sophia Weston with this week's sports wrap-up. The Penn State football coaching staff welcomed the new players for the next season with their second annual signature event. Nicole Barros has more.
It's National Signing Day, where Penn State fans will get their first full look at James Franklin's 2015 recruiting class. Franklin held a press conference prior to the signature event at Rec Hall to discuss the 25 new football recruits.
You know, we've added depth, we've added talent. And I think we got really good fits.
In his second season as head coach, Penn State was able to lock up 12 four-star recruits, and Franklin held true to his goal of dominating the state.
We got 7 out of the top 10 players in the state of Pennsylvania to stay home. You know, we believe in this state. We believe in the education. We believe in how these guys are going to be prepared to come and be successful here academically.
Franklin introduced the coaching staff, acknowledging their hard work throughout the recruiting process. Assistant head coach and co-defensive coordinator Brett Pry explained what the event means to the Penn State community.
I think our fans, as passionate as they are, they deserve this. They deserve a first glance, a first opportunity to see the new players, to see the new addition.
At the event, 3 of the early enrollees addressed the home crowd, including incoming quarterback Tommy Stevens.
You know, there's not a place like this place. It's, you know, it's unbelievable. And, I only took one visit here, and that was enough to show me that this is the place for me. I've loved it ever since.
It was a successful day here in Happy Valley as the Penn State football team finished with the top 15 recruiting class for 2015. For PSNtv, I'm Nicole Barros.
Penn State men's hockey finished their first home Big Ten sweep and first season sweep, defeating Wisconsin 4-1 in Pegula Ice Arena on Saturday. PJ Musco made 27 saves and 4 different players scored on the Badgers. The Badgers almost made the game even at 2-2 in the second period, but the referees ruled it off due to Wisconsin players' high stick. Nittany Lion James Robinson swept in to score 88 seconds later, bringing the score 3-1. Eric Audio capped off the game during a Penn State power play and scored within a minute, with a minute 34 seconds remaining. Penn State men's basketball beat Nebraska 56-43 at home on Saturday. Nebraska trailed by 11 points late in the game, but came back to close within 3 points. Penn State was able to pull away right before the last 3 minutes of play. Geno Thorpe led the offense with 14 points, followed by Brandon Taylor and DJ Newbill with 11 each. The Nittany Lions were 9 of 21 from long range and out-rebounded Nebraska 39-26. The team will take on Ohio State on Wednesday in Columbus, followed by Maryland on Saturday at home. The Lady Lions beat Purdue yesterday 54-50 in Indiana. Kiki Civilian posted a career high with 10 points, and Alex Harris registered a personal best of 13 rebounds. Lindsey Spann scored a game high of 16 points, landing her on the top 10 freshman scoring list with 336 points altogether. The Lions held the lead with 1 minute 38 seconds remaining after Sierra Moore hit a jumper, putting Penn State at 49-47. The team will play Michigan this Wednesday at 7 p.m. at home. The men's lacrosse opened the season with a 15-8 win over the University of Vermont at home on Saturday. The team is now 4-1 in season openers under head coach Jeff Tambroni. 8-8 Lions scored on the Catamounts with sophomore Matt Florence and junior TJ Sanders each scoring 3 goals. Sanders posted his 19th multi-goal game of his career. The Lions opened the first quarter with 5 goals against Vermont's 1. The team hits the road this weekend to play Loyola Maryland on Saturday. And that's all for this week's sports. PSN News will be right back after this.
Wow, these are really good.
You act surprised. Practice makes perfect.
You don't have to be perfect to be a perfect parent. There are thousands of teens in foster care who don't need perfection. They need you.
Enroll, we say. We want you to be okay. Enroll, we say. Take care, people, for goodness sake.
There's a plan for every budget, so don't accept defeat.
Now you can get covered and still...
Buy me treats.
You take care of your pets. Now it's their turn to take care of you. Visit GetCoveredAmerica.org to learn about your health insurance options.
Oh, look, a redhead.
Staring contest.
You still got it.
I know.
Come alive with the forest.
The dad was cute.
You were looking right at us.
Visit discovertheforest.org to find a forest near you.
All right, you ready for some baseball trivia?
Let's do it.
What year produced the most no-hit games in the big leagues?
7 no-hitters in 1990.
Wow, that's right. Now a question that's not trivial. How many children will witness bullying this year?
Huh.
The answer? 3 out of 4.
75%?
That's wow. Right. How many of them will say something?
Kids want to help, but don't know how. Teach them how to stop bullying and be more than a bystander at stopbullying.gov.
Valentine's Day is the end of this week. Kristen Garone visited Pollock Commons to find out students' plans.
I'm here in Pollock Commons Dining Hall to find out what people are doing on Valentine's Day. Here's what they said.
For Valentine's Day, I might come to the Pollock dinner. I guess it just depends on what my plans are. My boyfriend's coming in, so whatever he wants to do.
On Valentine's Day, my mom is coming to visit me for just because Valentine's Day is a day that we always spend together as a family.
Truthfully, I'll be working. I can't pass up the money. It's going to be a long day, but it's worth it in the long run.
Some students celebrating Valentine's Day at Penn State may look forward to seeing visiting family and friends. Others looking to have a nice dinner now have a close and inexpensive option. Pollock Commons, along with the other on-campus dining halls, allow students to have a sit-down dinner served to them for a small fee charged to their meal plan. Many students are excited by this idea.
This Valentine's Day, I'm definitely coming back to Pollock for dinner. Last year they had a chocolate fountain and strawberries and different kinds of fruits, so it was delicious last year. I think it'll be delicious again this year.
It's supposed to be like a candlelit dinner for two, really romantic.
Whether students don't want to be bothered by the holiday or are heading to the dining hall dinner, there's no shortage of activity both on and off campus. Reporting from the love-filled air of Happy Valley, I'm Kristen Garone. And that does it for us here at PSN News tonight for February 9th, 2015. Thanks for joining us, and make sure to check us out on Twitter at PSN News.
And make sure to watch us every Monday night on our YouTube channel. Have a good night, and thanks for watching.